Hello, and today we are making Swiss chard quiche.
Yes, and now we are cutting the chard.
Now this is a red chard, you can use whatever color of chard you want, the white, yellow.
But this is the one we had, so we used it.
Yep.
And now we are cutting the stems, because we don't like it.
We like it.
The stems?
It's just different time of cooking, this is why we cut it. We love it, actually.
So this time we love it. Usually we take the stem.
No, it depends on the plant. In the chard, you eat the stem.
And now we are cutting onions.
Chopping
onions. And we like onions, so we put quite a lot.
Yep, we do.
And I think the onions were sweet.
When you fry onions, they're sweet.
Yeah, they tasted really sweet. And really good, don't get me wrong. I like them.
You need to have big enough frying pan for the chard.
So now we put some olive oil.
Always use
olive oil.
It's healthy for you.
Yes.
You add the
chard stems. Chard.
You add the leaves.
It looks like a lot, but it shrinks when you fry it. So
okay, this is how it looks after shrinking.
And then you oil the pan.
And you spread it evenly. But actually, maybe just to show you the amount.
And then you add eggs.
Yeah, can you say how many?
We had five
eggs.
And some breadcrumbs.
Yes. This cheese is goat salted cheese. Very nice goat cheese. This is why I don't add a lot of salt, because the cheese itself is very salty.
And you break it down with a fork.
Exactly. You don't want too big bits, because then you'll have one very salty bite.
Mm-hmm. And then you put it on, and then you put it in the oven.
Yes, on 180 degrees for at least half an hour.
And then it comes out looking like this.
We didn't film ourselves eating it.
But it was very yummy, I assure you. Bye.
Enjoy your pie.
It's not pie, it's quiche.
Okay.